Steve said, let's do a collab. I said, I'll fly to London. See you Sunday. You know,
that's how it is.
About 140 years ago, this ramp was used by the British military to launch a type of torpedo that seemed impossible. Like, when you hear how the Brennan torpedo worked, your intuition just tells you that it shouldn't.
The Brennan torpedo doesn't have an internal power source. Instead, it's powered from the outside, which is already quite unusual. Inside the torpedo is a spool of cable, and via some pulleys, the cable makes its way through the center of the propeller at the back of the torpedo. And to get the torpedo to go forwards, you pull the cable backwards out of the torpedo. And just intuitively, it feels like it shouldn't be possible to make something go forwards by pulling it backwards.
So I suppose the torpedo would slide down like a pair of these things. Obviously, it's really broken, but it was pulled by cables. So the cables would have come from over there. There should be a location there where there would have been steam engines pulling on the cables. I don't know if we can get over there. I don't fancy hopping over that fence, to be honest. I have no reason to believe that it didn't work because its use is well documented, but at the same time, there doesn't seem to be any working models of the Brennan torpedo, so there aren't any videos that I can watch or anything like that. And I really like to see things working with my own eyes, so I had to make it real.
This is what we came up with. It follows the basic principle of the Brennan torpedo. You see, the cable passes through the axle. It comes out the other side and goes around these pulleys here so that when you pull on the cable, it causes the spool to turn. The spool is attached to the axle, and so the propeller turns as well. And honestly, holding this model in my hands, the reality of it makes it seem even more impossible. Like, I'm applying a force backwards, so that's gonna pull the torpedo backwards, but it's causing the propeller to rotate in such a way that it's pushing the torpedo forwards. So these two forces are in a battle with each other. And my intuition says that, like, maybe under perfect conditions when there's no friction, no resistance, no energy loss at all, maybe these two forces will cancel out exactly and the torpedo will just remain stationary. But there's just no way you could get more energy out of the propeller than you put into the cable. Before we try to solve that mystery, let's see if this thing actually works. And look, there it goes. Like, it barely goes forwards, but it does go forwards. And to be clear, this didn't work the first time around. These are all the iterations of the propeller. We could have spent a bit longer optimizing the design, but it's a proof of concept. Like, the thing goes forward when you pull the cable backwards. If you want to have a play with the design, I'll leave a link in the description for the files, free for anyone to download, of course. Though, if I was going to sell the designs, I'd need some kind of online store, but I'd want a system that took care of all aspects of the business, not just the store, in which case I could use the sponsor of this video, Odoo. That's because Odoo is an all-in-one management software for entrepreneurs with a whole load of business applications built in, like invoicing, project management, inventory, and they're all designed to make your life easier. The first Odoo application is free for life, including unlimited hosting and support. The project management app, for example, helps you track progress, deadlines, and budgets, and it's really customizable so you can prioritize what matters most for your business. It offers three different views to organize your projects. There's the Kanban view, where you move tasks around like sticky notes to keep projects flowing. Then there's the Gantt view that shows you a visual timeline for tracking schedules and deadlines. And for the nitty-gritty details, there's List view. I don't know if I've said this before, but I'm a big fan of batch actions. Well, List view has batch actions too. All these views are customizable, and you can share those custom views with your colleagues so everyone has quick access to the data they need. Because all Odoo apps are linked, when you log time in the project app, for example, that data syncs instantly with timesheets. And from there, you can track costs and budgets and team performance and so on. Odoo removes a whole bunch of manual steps, basically. Removing manual steps is another thing that I'm a big fan of. You can also add notes and files directly to tasks and schedule meetings from within the app, and it's fully synced with your calendar. So whether you've got a business idea or you're looking to streamline your operations, Odoo can help you stay organized and efficient. To start using your first app for free, click the link in the description. So I've come up with an explanation for the torpedo paradox. Yes, that's what I'm calling it. And I think the explanation is quite satisfying. And actually, I think it relates to a video Derek from Veritasium made about sailing downwind faster than the wind. In that video, Derek describes a vehicle that can travel in the direction that the wind is going, but faster than the wind. And it's propelled by the wind, which seems impossible. Like if a vehicle's being pushed by the wind, once the vehicle reaches the same speed as the wind, then the relative speed of the wind is zero, and surely the vehicle can't go any faster after that. I thought I'd run my explanation of the Brennan torpedo past Derek to see if he could spot the similarities that I see.
One of the things that feels intuitive is that, like, if you could make the friction of that spool unspooling, like, very low.
Yeah.
Then it feels to me like you almost need no force at all to pull this out the back.
Okay, so that was gonna be the first part of my explanation, right? So let's imagine a situation, there's no propeller here, right? Mm-hmm. We'll take that away. And let's imagine just by some physics miracle, there's no friction, there's no resistance at all. Right? When you first pull on it, there is gonna need to be a force because this has got to accelerate.
Sure.
Right?
Yeah.
But once it's up to speed, mm-hmm. it's just you don't need, it's just gonna come out, right?
Yeah.
If I hold on to it during that acceleration phase and then I let go, I can just be then guiding it out, right? Mm-hmm. And it's just gonna be stationary. But then when we add the propeller, that resists being turned. And not only during the acceleration phase when you're overcoming the inertia of the propeller, but actually there'll always be resistance to the turning of the propeller because it's pushing against the water that's around it. In other words, it's only the presence of the propeller that leads to there being tension in the cable. So when we're analyzing the system, those are the only forces we need to worry about. It's the propeller pushing the water backwards that has a reaction force on the propeller that pushes the torpedo forwards. And that reaction force also resists the turning of the propeller, which creates tension in the cable. That needs to be true from an energy point of view. Like, you have to be doing work against something to get the thing to go forwards. You're doing work against a force, which is the tension in the cable. That tension ultimately comes from the fact that the propeller is pushing on water. So the work you put into the system via the cable ultimately goes into pushing water out the back of the torpedo. But that's not going to cut it as a satisfying explanation. We really need to look at the forces for that.
It feels like the amount that you pull here, the amount of force that you pull here, will be roughly equal to the amount that this is pushing on the water,
yeah,
plus any sort of extra friction that you have in there.
Yeah.
So it feels like, in fact, you'll have to tug harder then you'll be able to apply force to the water,
yeah,
because you're always gonna have some other friction and losses and stuff.
It's quite hard to analyze when it's a propeller because of
fluid dynamics.
It's complicated.
I had the same thing when I was trying to do the downwind vehicle.
Yeah.
I was like, yeah, but there's lift and it's like.
So here's my idea, right?
Yeah.
We switch to levers. And I wanna try and convince you that the lever version of this is equivalent. So instead of a propeller pushing a mass of water backwards out of the torpedo, we're going to use a lever to push a mass out the back of the torpedo. So the lever is like the propeller and the mass is like the water. The big difference is with a propeller, it's continuously pushing water, but here it's like one shot,
yep,
and then it's done. But you could imagine,
yeah,
you know, like a circle of them, like a paddle steamer.
Paddle wheel, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Yep. And then like a conveyor belt.
Weight.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So hopefully that feels like not too much of a departure from the propeller, but now we can more easily analyze the forces. So suppose we decide to pull on the cable with a force of 1 newton. So what force is the pulley feeling? Well, the tension in the cable is 1 newton everywhere. So the pulley is feeling a force of 2 newtons. And in case that doesn't sit right with anyone, just imagine the vertical case. If I have a 1 newton weight here, I can balance the pulley by pulling down here with 1 newton also. Or I can replace my hand with another 1 newton weight. And so of course the force I'm feeling up here is just the total weight of these two. In other words, 2 newtons. So the pulley feels a force of 2 newtons, but it's anchored to the torpedo. So the torpedo is pulled backwards via the pulley with a force of 2 newtons. So far it seems like the torpedo should be pulled backwards. But what about the lever? The lever is also anchored to the inside of the torpedo. Well, this end of the lever is feeling a force of 1 newton from the cable. And on the other side of the lever, the reaction force of the mass is also applying a force of 1 newton. So the pivot point of the lever is feeling a force of 2 newtons forwards. And because it's anchored to the inside of the torpedo is feeling a force of 2 newtons forwards. So the 2 newtons backwards from the pulley and the 2 newtons forwards from the lever cancel each other out, and so the torpedo goes nowhere.
So you've got 2 newtons backwards, 2 newtons forwards. It shouldn't go anywhere.
Bada bing, bada boom.
There you go. Okay. Now, here's the trick. You move the pivot point.
You sneaky bugger.
Yeah. So now we've got mechanical advantage, right, in the cable.
Now the cable is twice as far from the pivot point as the mass. So the cable has mechanical advantage. So if we wanted to continue applying a force of 1 newton to the mass, the cable would only need a force of 0.5 newton. And again, that's something we're familiar with when we're talking about horizontal levers and gravity and masses and things like that. Like when I've got mechanical advantage, I don't need as much force on this side to keep the mass on that side from falling. So the total force on the pivot is now 1 newton plus 0.5 newton. That's 1.5 newtons. So the torpedo is being pushed forwards with 1.5 newtons via the pivot of the lever. But what about the pulley? What's that doing now? Well, since we're only pulling on the lever with 0.5 newton, that's the tension in the cable, 0.5 newton. And again, you've got 0.5 newton on both sides of the pulley. So the pulley is feeling a force of 0.5 newton plus 0.5 newton. That's 1 newton. So the pivot is pushing the torpedo forwards with 1.5 newtons, and the pulley is pulling the torpedo backwards with just 1 newton.
You've got 1.5 forwards, 1 back. That's 0.5 newton forwards net. So the torpedo goes forwards. So really it's mechanical advantage.
And just in case you weren't convinced by all that theoretical talk, here's the lever setup in real life. So this trolley here is like the torpedo, right? This is the lever. That lever gets pulled via the cable, which goes via the pulley. This is the mass. I just found the heaviest thing that I could, which happened to be a pestle and mortar. It's got its own trolley because it moves independently of the torpedo. So let's see what happens when we pull backwards with the cable. So there you go, the mass is ejected out this way and the torpedo moves forward as a result. Just for completeness, let's see what happens when you don't have mechanical advantage. There you go, the mass is ejected out the back and the torpedo goes nowhere. For completeness, let's see what happens when we have mechanical disadvantage. There you go, the torpedo and the mass both go backwards. But anyway, the point is it's mechanical advantage. And the way that applies to the actual torpedo is you can apply a small force at the cable and get a large force at the propeller. And just like in any situation where you have mechanical advantage, there's a trade-off between force and distance. Like, it's easy for me to lift this mass up because of the mechanical advantage I have, but I have to move my end a lot to get the mass to move just a little bit. And so to get the Brennan torpedo to work at all, you have to pull the cable out like crazy, just really, really fast. According to the Royal Engineers Museum, you'd be pulling out 4 kilometers of cable for every 1 kilometer that the Brennan torpedo moved forwards. It's worth saying that it's not so easy to see where the mechanical advantage is happening with an actual propeller versus this lever setup. And that's because, well, fluid dynamics is complicated and there are lots of variables like the angle of the blades, the size of the blades, the spacing of the blades, all these different things. But one thing that is quite straightforward to see is if you want to increase your mechanical advantage, given a fixed propeller geometry, you can just increase the size of the drum that the cable wraps around. And in fact, you can see on this Brennan torpedo at the Royal Engineers Museum, they've cut a panel away so you can see those spools. And they're almost as wide as the torpedo itself.
With the Blackbird, you're going in the same direction as the force, but more. Mm-hmm. Whereas here, you're pulling backwards and it's going forwards.
Yeah.
But there's a particular setup from the video where it's pretty much identical, in my opinion. Can you think what I'm...
On the treadmill.
Treadmill.
See, the Blackbird on the treadmill is no different to the Blackbird on land, except you've shifted to the reference frame of stationary air. But in this reference frame, it's just like the Brennan torpedo in stationary water. The rubber road of the treadmill is just like the cable coming out the back of the torpedo. It's pulling on the wheels of the Blackbird and making them spin, just like the cable of the torpedo is making the spool spin. And in both cases, that leads to the turning of a propeller.
You know, I also struggled, and I feel like a lot of people struggle with the sort of fluid dynamics of turbines and pushing air back, and it just feels all very mystical. So at some point, I came up with this idea of a steel cable, which is just running down the desert that's running at a certain speed. And then I imagined having just this platform with some wheels, and I'm just laying on it on my back, and I'm just holding onto the cable, flying down the desert. And then you think about, okay, what if I had a little generator that just pulls out a tiny amount of power out of the wheel. And then you stick a little motor on top of the on top of this cable, and you just very slowly climb us forward on the cable. It's like, for me, that it starts to become a little intuitive that, like, actually we can go faster than the cable is going.
And there's something about making it solid like that.
Yeah.
So with air, it's kind of flowing around you, but with a cable, you can lock onto it. And the similar thing with this, with the lever setup. Imagine that the mass is really heavy. Just stick my fist down on it, and it's stuck, right?
Yeah.
And then it's obvious what's gonna happen.
Yeah.
And it's the same thing, you just grip onto the cable. You can't grip onto the wind, but you can grip onto the cable, and you can see it, right?
Yeah.
The real Brennan torpedo actually had two cables coming out the back. And by some really clever mechanism, it was possible to steer the Brennan torpedo towards its target by changing the relative speed of the two cables that were coming out the back. I'd love to get into how all that stuff works, but I think it's probably beyond the scope of this video.
By some measure, the Brennan torpedo was the first ever guided torpedo. It was eventually superseded by a torpedo that had an internal power source so that it could be launched from a ship. It still had a cable coming out the back, though. The cable wasn't for power. Instead, it was for sending steering signals so that that type of torpedo could be guided as well. And in fact, the Brennan torpedo was only ever used for 15 years, and it was never used in anger, which perhaps explains why there aren't any working models around. But at least now there's this one.
So you're not going to claim that I derricked you on this one, are you?
No, not this time.